Hi, welcome to an Arduino tutorial from RoboJax. In this video, we are going to see how we can decode the keys for these silver and black remote that are sold on eBay using this infrared receiver and Arduino. For example, when one key is pressed, it will tell you which key have been pressed. I will also show you how you can use your own remote for any TV or another player that you have using Arduino to control and devices or turn on and off something using Arduino with any remote that you have. And we will see how we can learn this. You can get the code for this project by clicking on the link in the description below, which will take you to robojax.com/learn/Arduino. Let's get started with this. In this video, we're going to see how we can use these two remote control and detect them. I will also show you how you can use your own remote for any TV or another player that you have using Arduino to control devices or turn on and off something using Arduino with any remote that you have. The link will be provided for the library, but for this one, you can use either this actual small module like that, bare module, or maybe use as a PCB. Does not matter. These remotes are majority of the codes are the same, but because it has more keys, this has 21 and this has 17 keys. So for that reason, I've written code. So you just type or select the type as a B for black or W for white, and all the code will work for you. They're sold on eBay. Both will come with either with this. I've bent this, but with this receiver. Or you will get this receiver on a PCB. Decoding varies, so whatever this decodes is different or receives than this. So this receives one thing of the same remote and this receives the other thing. For that reason, I've written the code to make up for those differences. And once you receive your package, whatever it is, this or this, black or this white, it should just work fine. So we are connecting it to Arduino and the result will be displayed on the serial monitor. Some of the kits that is sold also, they give you this infrared transmitter, so you can send signal and detect it with this. So this one has written on it VS1838B, and this module has also written on it VS1838B. As you can see, the legibility of these two varies significantly. Let me put it at some angle so you can read it better. You see, on the left side, this PCB seems to be very hardly, not as legible as the one that is on the right. But regardless, both of them work perfectly fine. And the beauty of this PCB is that when it detects or receives code, this light blinks, which is very good. It helps us understand when the code is received. There's a data sheet. Some manufacturer label it as TL1838. And in terms of voltage, operating voltage, 2.7 to 5.5 volts. Receiving distance 10 to 15 meter. This is very long. And the quiescent current, when there is no signal, we are getting typically 0.8 or a maximum of 1.5 milliampere. And here they've explained the frequency, which is 38 kilohertz, how the waveforms are outputted from this device. And this is the angle of operation, 70 degrees, and the distance they show is 15 meters. And the input frequency here again, the transmitter must send the 38 kilohertz to get it. Let me explain now the wiring. So you can either use this as a module or use this module without a PCB. In both cases, they are the same. If I hold this like this, this is a VCC, this is the ground, and that is the signal which will be connected to pin 11. See here, this one says negative. The right one is connected to the ground, the middle one is connected to 5 volts on Arduino, and the last one, which is labeled as S, the signal, it's connected to pin 11, to VCC, and then ground, and this is for the signal which will go to pin 11. Make sure that you understand that this is a flat side, and this is the side that you can see on the picture, and the signal is on this side, as shown here. Now let me explain the code. When you install the library, this is part of the library, receive pin 11. So we set the pin 11 or whatever pin that you want to use. In my case, I used 11. And then the type here, you type either W with capital or B for black, W for white, and it must be inside single quote. Double quote will not work. Make sure to follow that because it's character. In car type, you put single quote and then PCB. And if you're using this one, you put PCB equal 1. And if you're using this module, just put equal 0. And then we are initializing the we are creating an instance of this class with passing the PCB input pin for the receiver. And below this line, except these three, you do not change unless your remote control is totally different. Otherwise, for these two remote control, it works fine. And I've created one array called white remote PCB. So this is the code for the white remote when you're using PCB module, because this PCB module reads it one way and this reads it the other way. So these are the code for that, for channel minus channel. These are all the code for that, for all the keys. And then we have another array of type integer. Here it says white remote. This is without PCB, and this array will be used when this module is there. You don't have to worry, it will be taken care of automatically. And after that, we define the keys for the white remote. So these are the keys. When the code is detected, we print this on the screen telling what key have been pressed. And this is for black remote. These are the values for this black remote when without PCB. And this is a black remote, and we have PCB at the end. These are the codes for the when you use PCB. And these are the black remote key name or labels. And this is the result when the code result comes. This is an instance of this class. Inside the setup, we have 9600 baud. When I press a monitor here, this is very important that it must match 9600 baud. Otherwise, you will not be able to read the text. And this is just a text on the screen. IR receive enable IR IPIN. So this initializes a pin 11 to start receiving. Inside the loop, this is very simple. Here it says IR receive dot decode, and we pass the result to it. And here we get the result. Result dot value is our result, so we pass it to RoboJack's validate code that I've written, which is below. I'm gonna explain it next. And then IR resume. This just resumes the loop, waiting 100 milliseconds. It continues. In case if you want to read the actual code that is sent by the remote, just remove this, make it uncomment, and it will print the code for you on the serial monitor. Otherwise, this will be just a decoded code, like CH21 or whatever key is pressed will be displayed. Now let me explain this code. When you pass the result, it comes to this function, and we call it CD, the code that you pass, the decoded code. So CD or code. This integer found is an internal variable that I use to validate the code found. Here we check if type is equal. These two equal means comparison or comparing. So equal capital W and PCB not equal true. When you set it equal 0, that means not equal true. So we check if it's not PCB and it's white, then this code from here to here will run. So this this is a loop that runs, and here it gets the array of white remote without the PCB and checks it. And if the code that the user entered is equal, the user entered is equal this value of array with I is 1, 2, 3 up to all those numbers, and then we press the key pressed, and from here we get the text. white remote key, so the key name will be printed, and we also set this found equal 1, so later on will be used. Otherwise, if the type is equal W and this 2 ampersand means and, so this must be true and this must be true. We just put PCB. I didn't put any equal sign because it's a boolean. We can use that way. I could use equal 1, which is extra, so this would work, but I just put it PCB, which means if it's true, this must be true and this must be true. If that is true, then we run this one, which has PCB. And else if, otherwise, if the black one, if you use the black one, then again, if with a PCB, this code will run. Else, which means all the possibilities are eliminated, so then it must be without the PCB, would be this module, then this code will run. When that finishes, here is the found will be used, the found variable. We say if found is not true, that means not true, then we check for something. When you press a key continuously, you get FFFF. So we say if it's not equal this value of hex integer, then we say key unknown, because it's not found and it's not this, then we pay unknown. The job of this F condition is also to eliminate this FF, so you will not see it on the screen at all. And if you want to do, let's say, if OK is pressed and you want to do something, or this arrow on the right side, whatever, just for simplicity, let's say if OK is pressed, this for black key, this is for the checking the black key remote. So here we say if this value is equal, inside the double quote, put OK. Here we can set a pin high. I'm gonna say pin 9 high. So this will just turn a send signal to pin 9 of this Arduino, and it could be a relay, it could be motor, it could be light, whatever you want. You can do the control like that, and you can put multiple conditions for each key. You can do a different thing here. Once you install the library, you can go to File, Examples, and then you should see IR Remote. Then Receive Demo. Select this one, which is this code. Make sure that this is pin 11. If you're connecting another pin, just change it to that pin that you are using. And then open the serial monitor. Now this is a serial monitor. I'm just pressing a key here. So this is the actual key that is coming from the keyboard. This FF is as a result of continuous press. Let's say I'm pressing 8. You see, this is all FF. Initially, at the beginning, it receives the code, and after that, it just prints FF. See, I press it only one time, that's the code. And another time, that's the code. But if I press it continuously, I get that FF. Same thing with this one. If I press it continuously, I get this value. And if I press it just once, this is a value, and that was a moment that continued. So this device receives continuously the signal, and as soon as it gets the signal, after that, if the same signal is received, it just prints out this FFFF. For that reason, I've put the code in place to remove this and only print the key that is known, or if the key is unknown, you will get unknown value. I think the LG remote, this is for TV. I press volume down. As you can see, this is actual code, but if I continuously press it, I will get FFF. That is from the decoder. If I press 5, those are the values. Favorite. So we can read any remote's code here and then decode it, and based on that, you can turn on and off something with this remote using Arduino. If you want to use any remote that you have and by pressing a key do something with Arduino, you can just modify this code that I have read the code the way that I shown you and then put them here accordingly. That just 0x is at the beginning, and the code that you read, just put it here and put the code reference for yourself, and then the code that you have and put the labels for each key, and then take some action based on the key using the Arduino. Now I'm demonstrating. I've set this to white, to W, and then PCB equal 1. And this is the PCB version of the code. So this is the PCB version of the code. And then let me, if I press CH plus, we should get this code. So this is now also printing the code. So this is the code that this printed, and also it printed CH. For this double arrow to this side, we are getting this B1B. For the plus, we are getting that one, and so forth. So I've enabled this to display the code. If I just comment this out, we'll be getting the key that is pressed. Sometimes it gives you error. That's due to the quality of these keys. Now I have set this to W, which is white, and PCB equals 0, because I'm not using PCB, I'm using the other module, and I have to hold it with my finger again in order to eliminate any false reading or noise. Equal 100 plus 2 6 left, and then channel. So if you are using it, make sure to solder it or have very tight connection, because this DuPont wire that I'm using, this the wire for this pins are very thin and it's loose. As you can see, it's reading very well. This to B for the black, I'm testing the black. And also PCB equals 0, because PCB is not used. As you can see, because this is very loose with a connector, we are getting some of those values, but if I hold it tight, we will get the right value. Left arrow down, I'm pressing OK. So 5, sometimes you will get some error due to the key quality, but generally it works very well. Now I've set the type to black and the PCB equal 1, because I'm using PCB, not this bare module. So I press OK and it prints OK. Right arrow, down arrow, left arrow, any of these numbers that I print, press, it will display. From time to time you might get error due to the quality of these keys or some other noise. Thank you for watching. This was how to decode the code for these keys of these two types of remote. Please subscribe so you can get updates of my upcoming videos, and also follow us on our Facebook. The link for the Facebook is at the bottom of the description link. If you learned something from this video, please don't forget to thumb up. If you have comment or questions, please post it in the description below. I try to answer and reply.